Good morning, students. In the last class, we studied responses of organisms to abiotic factors. In that, we studied the organism shows a great range of ability to respond or survive in variety of extreme environmental conditions. And their response varies. It may be physiological adaptations. For example, you have studied that is regulators, which will maintain their constant body temperatures, or they may go for migration. They may go for migration if the environmental condition is not suitable, a temporary vacating the place, or they may suspend their metabolic activities temporarily. These are different way they can survive in their own habitat, the extreme conditions also. For example, in a desert, madhyana antadre 50 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸಿಯಸ್ ಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಅದೇ ನೈಟ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ತುಂಬ ಕೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಅದೇ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ಲಿ, ಅದೇ ಪ್ಲೇಸಲ್ಲಿ, ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ಯಾಟಲ್ಲಿ ಅವುಗಳು ಎರಡು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಮ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ಗೆ ಅನ್ನಂಗೆ ಹೊಂದ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಅಬಿಲಿಟಿ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೇಷನ್ಸ್. ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೇಷನ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಟು ಸರ್ವೈವ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ ಅಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. It may be the morphological characteristic or physiological characteristic or behavioral characteristic of an organism which makes that organism to survive and reproduce in its habitat. ಅದರ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಅದಿರುವ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ಸರ್ವೈವ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು. ಅಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಓವರ್ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್. ಅದು ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಮ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ವೇರಿ ಫ್ಲಕ್ಚುಯೇಷನ್ ಇದ್ರೂ ಆ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ಬದುಕಬೇಕು. ಆ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್, ದಟ್ ಅಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಶೇಪ್, ಬಾಡಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಾರ್ಫೊಲಾಜಿಕಲ್. ಫಿಸಿಯೋಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್, ಬಿಹೇವಿಯರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದರ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ಗಳು, ಅದರ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಆ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಅದನ್ನ ಆ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್ವೈವ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬದುಕುಳಿದು ರಿಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿಯನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ, ದಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೇಷನ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೇಷನ್, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಕ್ಯಾಂಗರೂ ರ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಸರ್ವೈವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಅಮೇರಿಕನ್ ಡೆಸರ್ಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಿಟ್ರಲಿ ನಾಟ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಆದ್ರೆ ಇಡೀ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ತೊಟ್ಟು ನೀರು ಸಹ ಕುಡಿಯುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಬಟ್ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ 90% ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ, 70-90% ಆಫ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಕಂಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್. ಫಾರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ವಾಟರ್. ದೆನ್ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಡಿರೈವ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಯಾಟ್. ಫ್ಯಾಟ್ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಆದವಾಗ ವಾಟರ್ ರಿಲೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಆ ವಾಟರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಂಗರೂ ರ್ಯಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾರ್ತ್ ಅಮೇರಿಕನ್ ಡೆಸರ್ಟ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾಟ್, ಯೂಸ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ಯಾಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದಾರ್ ಬೈ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಡಿಮಾಂಡ್. ಅಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅನದರ್ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬಿ ಅವಾಯ್ಡೆಡ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಯೂರಿನ್, ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಯೂರಿನ್ ದಾರ್ ಬೈ ಇಟ್ ಚೆಕ್ಸ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಲಾಸ್. ಒಂದು ಕಡೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಟರ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳುವುದಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಲಿಟ್ರಲ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಅನ್ನು ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಡಿಮಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಫುಲ್ಫಿಲ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಡಿಮಾಂಡ್ ಬೈ ಫ್ಯಾಟ್ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್. ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಟೈಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅದೇನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಯೂರಿನ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗುವಾಗ ವಾಟರ್ ಬೇಕು, ಅದನ್ನ ಅದು ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಯೂರಿನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೂ ವೇ ದ ಕಾಂಗರೂ ರ್ಯಾಟ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೆಡ್. ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫಿಸಿಯೋಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೇಷನ್, ಬೋತ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫಿಸಿಯೋಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೇಷನ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೆಸರ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಪನ್ಶಿಯಾ. ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ಇನ್ ಅ ಡೆಸರ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್, ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಡೆಸರ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಫ್ಯೂ. ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ಲೂಸ್ ದೇರ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್. ದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಸ್ಟೊಮ್ಯಾಟ, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಮೇಜರ್ ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ಇನ್ ಡೆಸರ್ಟ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೆಸ್. ಹೌ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಕೋಪ್ ಅಪ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ವೇರ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡೆಸರ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ದೇ ಶೋಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಲೀಫ್ ದೇ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಎ ಥಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯೂಟಿಕಲ್, ಎ ಥಿಕ್ ಕ್ಯೂಟಿಕಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಸಂಕನ್ ಸ್ಟೊಮ್ಯಾಟಾ. ಸ್ಟೊಮ್ಯಾಟಾ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸಂಕನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಲೋ ದ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎಪಿಡರ್ಮಿಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಎಪಿಡರ್ಮಿಸ್, ಬಿಲೋ ದ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎಪಿಡರ್ಮಿಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ಸ್ಟೊಮ್ಯಾಟಾ. and a layer of cuticle. We will see layer of cuticle. These are the two morphological adaptations done by desert plants to check the water loss. And some of the time around the stomata they possess hairy structures, hairs, so that which again prevents the water loss. And another one is opuntia. There are certain desert plants like opuntia, the cactus, where there is they literally shows the absence of leaf. When the soon after the formation of leaf, leaves will be shed off. The function of leaf is photosynthesis, that is taken up by the its fleshy stem. Opuntia name gottuntu papas kalli alla stem hige dappa neer tumukondaga mucilaginous stem it possesses. It is greenish, it performs the function of leaf, and leaves are replaced by spines for the protection. This is another morphological adaptation. And another, most of the mammals, those who survive in the colder regions, they have very short ear and the legs. Size of the leg and ears are very short. In mammals, those who are living in the colder regions, to avoid heat loss. Yakandre mammals, they are homeotherms. Body temperature is constant, they have to maintain. If the body size becomes more and the region which are exposed to area, if it is more in the colder regions, they have to try a lot, or more of energy is utilized in maintaining constant body temperature. So their intention is to reduce the area of the body, and that is by reducing the size of the leg as well as ears. And this principle is called as Allen's rule. Allen's rule says that the mammals, those who survive in the colder regions, will have short legs and ears. Short legs and ears of mammals is characteristic feature in colder regions. This principle is explained by Allen's. Hence, this rule is called as Allen's rule. Another thing you might have observed in as you go higher up in the altitudes, or when if you are mountain climber, if you are going for Himalayan peaks trekking and all, we feel like breathlessness, or we feel very fatigued, and there is a palpitation of heart will be there. Why this is? This reason is behind this. And this symptoms together we call it as breathlessness, or the heart palpitation, and fatigue, or difficulty in breathing. These symptoms together, that is a nausea will be there, and vaanti bandaga aagtade, hridaya badta jor aagtade, amale tumba sustu anustade, tumba swalpa nadilikku aagudilla, aa tara situations irtade. Aa symptoms together we call it as High altitude sickness. अंत ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ? High altitude sickness. We call it as high altitude sickness. This high altitude sickness in this person, ಇದು ಯಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತದೆ? High altitude sickness ಯಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತದೆ? Those who are in the high altitude regions, or those who are visiting high altitude regions, they feel nausea, heart palpitation, fatigue. Another symptom. When they come across with this symptom, is this symptom last for a long time? No. If we remain there for few days, our the high altitude sickness will goes. How it is? The body shows a physiological adaptations. Our body will adjust to that high altitude. How? By increasing the heart rate, and by producing more of blood production will be increased. And oxygen holding capacity of the hemoglobin decreases. Means very fast hemoglobin start releasing the oxygen to the cells. Fast oxygen will be released from the hemoglobin. Heart start beating very fast, and more RBC are produced from our bone marrow. These are the three way our body makes our body makes us to adjust to high altitude, and thereby we are able to overcome high altitude sickness. This is high altitude adaptations by human beings. It is a physiological adaptation. While short legs and ears of mammals in colder regions, it is a morphological adaptation. They may ask you in the exam, mention few physiological, or they may specify, explain three or two morphological adaptations or two physiological adaptations in specific for 2 marks, then you should be in a position. Kangaroo rat in the North America, this is a physiological adaptation. This is a physiological adaptation, and this is a physiological adaptation. This is a morphological adaptation. This is also a morphological adaptation. This we should know. Next one. Most of homeotherms, we have constant body temperature. All our metabolic reactions will work at its optimum level in the 37 degree Celsius. Namella body reactions are tumba efficient aagi kelsa maartave, ella reactions are tumba efficient aagirtave 37 degree Celsius. But we studied in first year, can you remember archaebacteria? Those who will survive in extreme environmental conditions, they may be present in the hydrothermal vent or in the very high salinity, or they may be present in the acidic environment. They are present in a very extreme environmental condition. And how it is? For example, in hydrothermal vent, temperature goes above 100 degree Celsius. Hydrothermal vent, temperature goes above 100 degree Celsius. Normally, we can survive, or our body can work very efficiently at 37 degree Celsius. See the difference. 100 degree, 37 degree. Is too high temperature, archaebacteria badaktade antandre. There, in that chapter also I told it is, there is certain chemicals, special chemicals present in their cytoplasm. It is a biochemical adjustment. It is a biochemical adjustment where different chemicals, special chemicals present in the cytoplasm of archaebacteria makes it able to survive in that harsh environmental conditions. At the same time, you see another extreme condition, that is fishes present in Antarctic water, in Arctic and in polar regions. The surface, it is a snow laden. Below, water is in the liquid condition, it is flowing. There you will see fishes, and depending on those fishes you will see polar bears and all other animals. And in that less than 0 degree Celsius is the temperature, below 0 temperature, how these fishes are surviving, and in the deep sea pressure is 100 times more than that of the atmospheric pressure. For example, our electric ray or ray fishes, flat fishes, and variety of other organisms, microbes and other organisms survive in the deep sea, where fishes is more than 100 times of that of atmospheric pressure. Kinta 100 pattu jaasti water pressure irthas to deep sea alli alisa organisms irthave. How it is possible for them to survive? Why their cells are not getting burst off? Why their cells are not shrinking them? That is because of special chemicals present in them. It is a biochemical adjustment. It is a biochemical adaptations. This is also a biochemical adaptation. These two are biochemical adaptation. That is, fishes in a very cold polar region, Antarctic water, as well as deep sea fishes, where pressure is very high. Pressure is 100 times more than that of the normal atmospheric pressure. Here temperature is less than zero, below zero. In that very extreme abiotic factors are existing, but still we can see organisms, plenty of organisms there. The credit should goes to the chemicals present in their cell cytoplasm. Chemicals present in their cell cytoplasm. Lastly, a behavioral adaptation is also possible. We told in the beginning, adaptation is morphological, physiological, and behavioral. Behavioral adaptation is there. Last one is behavioral adaptation. In the desert, if the mammals are there, they are homeotherms. But what about lizards are also there in the desert? These lizards are poikilotherms. Means they are not having their physiological adaptations for the fluctuations in the temperature. How they will able to survive in this varied temperature ranges? The lizards in the cold, those lizards present in the desert, if the temperature goes down, they take mud, they will take a bath of the mud, because where the mud soil is still hot there, and they will just go and they will roll themselves in the hot soil so that their body temperature will be increased. And if it comes, if the temperature is too high, they start go in search of burrows or any colder or shaded areas. Thus, behaviorally they are adjusting their behavior for the cold climate. It is taking the hot soil bath. If it is hot, they are going in search of shaded areas or burrows. They are behaviorally adapted to survive in the desert. These are 7 examples for adaptations. They may ask you for the exam for 5 marks. What is adaptation? Adaptation is any attribute of an organism, maybe morphological, physiological, or behavioral, that enables organism to survive and reproduce in its habitat. Give 5 examples or 4 examples. This example you have to say in detail. Kangaroo rat, which is surviving in the North American desert, where the fat derives its water requirement through fat metabolism and concentrating urine. And desert plants have a thick cuticle coat on the epidermis and sunken stomata. And upon, there are certain desert plants like cactuses, they totally devoid of leaves. Instead of that, the photosynthesis is done by fleshy greenish stem. Leaves are replaced by spines. In the colder regions, mammals possess very short legs and ears so as to decrease the heat loss, or energy can be survived in order to maintain the constancy of temperature. We call it as Allen's rule. In the high altitude, our body adjusts to, for the body will come out of the high altitude sickness through having the increased blood heart rate and increasing blood production, as well as decreasing the oxygen releasing capacity of the hemoglobin. And lastly, the archaebacteria, which can survive in the extreme, in a hydrothermal vent due to its biochemical adaptation. Same thing you will see in the Antarctic fish, as well as deep ocean fishes or organisms, which are survive in the very high pressure by producing or by having their special chemicals which are making them to survive in that specific conditions. And there are certain lizards in the desert, they show behavioral adaptation. Either they will get from the environment extra heat during the cold season, or in the summer season they try to avoid sunlight by hiding in the shady places. These are the few examples. They may ask this for 5 marks or 1 marks for this, or any of these, all these things for the maybe morphological, physiological, like that they may ask in specific, or for competitive exam they may ask from this. A question can be framed from the competitive exam as well. Okay, in the next class we will see. This is, till now we studied how organisms respond to the environment. You can study ecology at the level of organism. How an organism will respond to the different abiotic factors we studied. How an organism will survive in different abiotic and in different habitats with its adjustment, that is adaptations, we studied. Next, how a population will respond, or how a population will be there in an ecosystem or ecology. Ecologically, what is the response of a population, that we will see in the next class. What are the characteristic feature of a population with reference to ecology, everything we will see in the next class. Okay, thank you.